Hello, everyone. Today I will tell you about what is happening in crypto ransomware world in 2014. How do I know? Actually, I investigate the incidents in organizations, and I investigated a lot of them, actually more than 500. So I know 500 of dramatic stories. Some of them was with bad endings, some of them was with good endings. So anyway, I found some interesting things and I want to share it with you. So first of all, let's say a couple of words about what is ransomware today. Ransomware is a malware which somehow tries to restrict access to computer system, auto user data, and demand a ransom. And if 5 years ago, the ransomware was mostly the lockers, the programs which simply lock the user devices, but not encrypt the data. Now things have changed, and most of ransomware are actually cryptos. And today we will talk mostly about crypto ransomware. So I will show you some scary numbers. More than 7 million attacks were registered by our products in 2014. Almost 2 million of distinct users were attacked, and a wide range of ransom. This is for private person in Russia. But if you are an organization, then it will be for you like 8 times more expensive. What's about propagation? Classical way, drive-by downloads and botnet leads. It can be remote desktop protocol attack. It mostly happens with servers of organizations with weak password policy. But the main channel of distribution is emails. It's email attachments and links in phishing emails. So let's talk about this a little bit more. Main target of these emails are organizations. Why? Because organizations are very vulnerable if all the data are encrypted. It can not simply do normal work. And people in organization, they used to receive letters from unknown source. So, and if you will not proceed this email in time, maybe your boss will pissed off. So, yes, chance that somebody, anybody in organization will open an attachment are much higher. And the criminals are specially selected subject of the email. So such emails will be forwarded to some non-IT specialists, like accountants or lawyers. And they use the extensions of attachments are not widely known, but this non-IT specialist. You can see it on the slide. And they use some calming words in the attachments, like checked, verified, secured, okay, and the name of some antivirus vendors. One time I saw the attachment, it was in Russian, but you can translate it in English like free security lessons from Kaspersky.js. And of course it was not from Kaspersky, and of course it was not free. So here is, you can see some examples of such emails. First one is in Russian, and it's targeted the organizations. It's like letter from the court, and you can see the official symbols of Russian court. And second, email is in English, and it's targeted the private person. It's about tax refund, and criminals try to make it as personal as possible. They name the attachment the same, the name of the addressee. But of course it's all fake and it's all crypto ransomware. During our investigation we find out that the main reason of infection actually security misconfiguration, which happens in the user side. And here is the most popular of them, no antivirus at all. It was surprised for me personally that in 2014 there are still organizations that not use any antivirus software. And they use internet, they use email and open attachments, and of course it's end up like, please help my to decrypt my data back. Old version of antivirus without most modern advanced models. If anybody use not the latest version of our products, please update to the newest one. They are really better. And disable some of the models, bad idea. And not update databases often enough, also bad idea. And all of this security misconfiguration often happens in small state organizations like school, kindergartens, or hospitals. Why? It's personally break my heart because I had to receive letters like from, we are a small hospital from the city, north city of Russia, and we received email with strange attachment, and antivirus was disabled, and we opened an attachment, and all our data was encrypted, and all our patient history was encrypted, and we have no backup, please help us. And you need to answer like, sorry, but this is the strong encryption algorithm, and we cannot help you without the key. And it's personally break my heart. So why does it happen with these organizations? Here is an answer. Low salary in these organizations and low qualified staff, IT personnel, is of course it's, all end up to pure security performance. So you get what you paid for. It's not only about antivirus software. It's actually about IT personnel who will configure this antivirus software. So if you're a manager of such an organization, please make sure that you have both solid antivirus software and qualified IT personnel. So it will be not a sad story like this. Okay, what about technology improvement? Multi-gate crypto schemes. We will see it a little bit later when we will see the cases. Usage of script. Why? Because script can easily expand functionality and you can easily obfuscate it. And the use of legal tools. Who knows why? Who was on the whitelisting presentation today? Yes, because the legal tools are whitelisted. So they use SDeleter, WinRAR, GNUPG often. Tor, Bitcoin, and BitMessage, it's all for anonymity. And the, what about criminals themselves? They have partner ID, they have referral systems. We found some samples with partner ID field inside, and it was filled. So also we know the cases when they sell the whole packages to each other. So the prices start from $5,000. It's called package. It's server side and client side. You can configure it as you like. And we trace some Bitcoin wallets which was connected to the crypto ransomware. And we find out that in successful attacks, the income may be up to $25,000 a day in Bitcoins. And also, if you need additional functions, they are also available. Just pay the money and they implement it any way, any what you want. So, we know also interesting case where the victims, the private person, said, okay, I don't have the money to pay the ransom. What can I do? And the criminals answered, it's okay that you don't have the money. Just help us to distribute our software. And we will decrypt your data for free, and you will get even more money with us. So it's almost like the drug business. They involve the victims to the criminal, yes? And the interesting detail, in the messages which they left to the victims, they ask, please do not threaten us or insult us, because it's hurt their feelings. Interesting cases. First one I want to tell you about is Scatter. Scatter is now significantly involved, and it's now fully functional email worm. Actually, it encrypts the user data with enchased crypto schema with two asymmetric key pairs. What it for? Because in that case, key does not download it from the malware server and not sending to malware server. And still, the criminals can do the scheme where they can make the decryption tools, which will help only one victim. So if you're interested in how it's happened, ask me after presentation, I will tell you details. And also it have Trojan password stealing functionality inside, but the funny thing, it's still email password from email accounts, it's also still accesses data to Bitcoin wallets, but it's not sent this data to the server, no. It left to the user to send it manually. How it's happened? It's encrypt all the data, and the key to, needed to decrypt the user data in one service file. And it's left to the message to the user. So we can decrypt the two files for you for free, just to prove that we actually can do it. So send us two small files of your choice and this small service file. And the victim is sending it, and they receive the file in, decrypted, and they receive all passwords. And they also received the full log of the encryption. So they actually knew how much files was encrypted, what's the name of the files, what's the size, and they can do analysis and, it is organization, a lot of files, and, it's encrypted databases, and the backup archives was also encrypted, so it's jackpot. And for you, it will be like 2,000 euros in bitcoins. Yes. And it's self-distributed. How it's happened? It steals the password from email, connect to the server, download the headers from inbox folder, parse them, sort them, delete the service messages like no reply and others. On left addresses, it sends the copy of itself, a little bit modified, a little bit obfuscated, different. And it chooses randomly one of 15 varieties of email. All of them target lawyers in this modification, which I research. So what's happening? In next organization, they received the letter from the partners, not from unknown source, from the partners. And here is the say that you don't pay for our deal. Here's the details and attachment. And of course, lawyers and accountants eager to see what's inside and open it. And it all happens again. So it's automated propagation, but it's not all. They have highly automated system overall. They have automatically received emails from victims. They automatically decrypt the necessary files. They automatically evaluate by the log. Automatically answer it with Bitcoin wallet number and the amount of ransom. And when the payment is done on that Bitcoin wallet and that sum, it automatically sends the decryption tool back. So it's like business of the dream, you know? They do literally nothing. It's automatically propagate itself, it's automatically proceed, and they just check, open notebook, laptop, and just check how Bitcoin's going to the wallet. And it's also have the Twitter account, it's automatically informed, it's called CryptoBot, and you can see in Russian that client with this email is successfully received his. Actually, it's not updated since middle of December. The last message is in Russian, all keys were deleted. For some reasons, the criminals give up to use this Twitter account. But anyway, it's still there. And somebody make the analysis of these emails, which was the victims. It's schools, kindergartens. But interesting thing, there is one security firm which provide the IT security services. So they victims, so it was bad for their reputation. Okay, So next thing I want to tell you about, it's first cryptor for Android. I want to take a credit for Roman Unushik, who first make research on this. It's not signed. So actually the user needs to install it manually, and the user needs to uncheck the box install from third-party software outside the Google Play. It's discussed as codec for porn videos. And when the user is installed, it's encrypted its data with IS256, and it's locked the device with a screen like this. So you can see the translation that phone was blocked before because of watching porn with pedophilia and bestiality, and you need to pay a fine on that phone account. Yes, so and it shows you the pictures from your camera. So actually, like, we're watching you, we know what you are doing, so better to pay a fine. It's targeted the Russian and Ukrainian users because we find two modifications. It can be in Ukrainian language and Ukrainian phone number. But the good news is it's pretty simple. And it uses a static key inside. Actually, it's a hash from some password, which is not changing from modification to modification. So if you send us the body of this APT, we can decrypt your data easily. Okay, let's talk about what to expect in the future. I think it will be more ransomware, of course, because it's very profitable business, and I don't see why it can be changed in the nearest future. I think we will see the password stealing software, which will not only encrypt the data on your device, but it also will encrypt the data into the cloud service, like Google Drive. I think we will see more attacks on more non-Windows platform, especially on Android. Actually, we find some sample for cryptor for iOS, but it was not functional. It's not encrypt anything. It just have the encryption algorithm. Maybe it was like bad implementation. So we detect it, but it's actually not encrypting data. But I think in the future we will see this. And I think we can see the locus attack on such smart device. And I think if we will think about what the possible target of such attacks, I think it will be smart TV. Why it can be smart TV? Because smart TV is expensive, it's important. Smart TV usually big and heavy, and it's hard to take to the service. And if you will ask a serviceman to come to your house, you will pay money anyway. And this smart TV usually can be rooted. The user can run the third-party application on such device, and it have the email client inside. So the scheme of the attack can be the same. Like user received such email with strange attachment, open attachment on TV, and end up with locked device and demand on ransom. So I think it will be like this. Okay, it's all bad. Yeah, nothing we can do. Actually, no. There is three simple steps which help you to avoid ransomware threat. First of all, regularly backup all your important data and store it outside of your system. This is very important because every self-respected crypto ransomware now is hunting not only for documents but also for backup archives. So please store the backups outside of your system. Use more modern, updated, solid antivirus software. Install it anywhere you can want. You know, you can install it on TV if such TV is on Android platform. And if you're an organization manager, please raise the awareness of your users, because it will help a lot. So if you will follow these three simple steps, I'm sure you will be okay and no ransomware will hurt you. I finish for now. If anybody have any questions, I will be happy to answer it. No? Not anybody?
Okay, I have a question.
Then I have bonus ransomware for you. It's Trojan Crypto Wall 2.0. What is dangerous about this case? Because they use the email attacks to spread it, but they also use the flash player exploits. And what actually happens? The criminals buy the advertisement from Zeno AD, and Zeno AD is place these malicious banners on some highly ranked sites which managed by AOL, Yahoo, and Match.com, and user literally do nothing. They just visited the same site which we used to visit, and they end up with encrypted data and demand of ransom like 5,000 United States dollars in bitcoins. And the bad news is it's about encryption algorithm. It's very strong, so we cannot decrypt it easily. So it's very dangerous case. But anyway, if you will follow these three simple steps, in that case, you will be okay too. So, yes. We have 2 minutes to answer the questions, if anybody want to ask. No? Then let's drink. I don't drink alcohol. I drink no alcohol. Actually, I want to, you know, I want to go, I'm seriously want to, in the end of my life, go into the space, or perhaps on the moon, if I can. So in the end of my life, I must be famous, of course, rich, and healthy enough to actually can handle this struggle. So yes, I stopped drinking alcohol, I started making sports. So yeah. So I will be drinking orange juice, if you have.
I also have a question. I mean, this is interesting stuff. In the US, it's a real problem. Small businesses get hit with this stuff all the time.
Yes.
And the other unfortunate thing is they consider their network drive their backup, so they do think it's off of their system, but the network drive is available, so
yes, yes. Stuff if you make the backup system, please make sure that it can be like right. You can add the archive, but not actually delete it or modify it, old version. It's very important because ransomware now are hunting not only network drives, it's actually tries to connect the every network share. Even if it is not connected like logical drive, it will try, it will search. I know the samples, it will search for this. So please take the backup seriously. I start to do backup personally. You know, when I find out these cases, I start to do backup again. I don't do it for some time, but now I do. So.
Yeah, and I guess my other question is,
yes.
You know, so the small businesses that I see are unfortunately usually nonprofits that get hit with this. So, you know, it's a shop of like three people that are trying to help inner city kids you know, grow gardens or something like that. Do you see specific actors using specific techniques targeting like small businesses?
Small business, and then they you know, go after they do hospitals? Actually any that goal.
It's just a spam.
They will hunt anything they can reach, and they will send emails with any term for small business, for situation in Ukraine, for you know, tax refund and other, and you see it's automatically propagate itself. So maybe criminals from the beginning did not want to attack the small business, but things changed that this email worm automatically attack. So everybody is on the target, and please, we not make this research to make this funny presentation. We actually take it very seriously. We want to make our products better, and we have success. You know, we have better detection rate, early detection rate, and we continue this work. So yes, I see that I have overrun time.
Oh no, that's okay. That's okay. It started early, so that's actually like you still have several minutes. Yeah, you still have 5 minutes.
It's hot topic, you know. If anybody, yes.
So I heard that.
Maybe microphone, please.
Okay.
I don't hear you clear. You know, I'm not native speaker, so I need to clear.
Sorry.
It's loud and
Thank
clear.
You. Can you hear me now? Is this okay? So I heard that even if you pay the ransom, they still leave a backdoor on your system sometimes, and they just re-encrypt them next month. So you basically have to pay every single month to use your computer. Is that true?
It's not the rule. It's not the commonplace. But in some cases, yes, they actually steal your access data. You see, they have the additional functionality like password stealing. So they steal at least the password from your email. And they can access it via email. And I don't know what's exactly case do you mean, but I believe that it can be easily. So, and you know, maybe you will pay ransom and you will not have any decryption tool at all. This also can happen. So better to have a backup and do not pay. Why this business actually exists? Because people are paid. If nobody will ever pay a penny, they stop doing this. They do it because the people pay. So make a backup. If any happens, you will have a backup at least. Yes.
So one more question. So in the past, we used to see poorly implemented cryptography schemes that we could abuse to decrypt some of the files with previous ransomware. Are they using Win32 API? Are they using open source libraries? What are they doing to properly implement cryptography so that we can't sort of break their scheme?
Please, one more time, short and clear.
Sorry. So in the past, we were able to decrypt the files because of their flaws in implementation.
Yes. I have a bad news for you guys, because we can decrypt the files only if criminals make some mistake. They use simple schemes like SOAR, or they use statical password inside, and we have the sample, but now it's less and less chance that we actually can decrypt your data if it's already encrypted. Because criminals are smarter, and they start to use the legal tools, and if they use the legal tools like GNU-PG, so it's thousands of years to decrypt it, to brute force it. So. Without a master private key, we cannot do nothing. So, yes, I'm sorry to tell, but this is true, that less and less chance that we actually can decrypt data, yes. But in 2014, there are still was several such cases when can we actually help the data. And you know, this is when I feel good, because we can help, yes. And it's very sad to answer like we cannot help you.